Are you going on a cruise and wondering what to wear, what to pack, how to plan your cruise outfits? I'm going to go through everything that you need to know in this video coming up ahead. Hi there, I'm Ilana from the website lifewellcruise.com. Welcome or welcome back to my channel. Now, we all know that planning for a cruise is different than a land vacation, and planning what to wear is no exception. There are dress codes, and obviously that affects what you're going to wear and pack for your cruise. So in this video, I'm going to be sharing with you the outfits that you'll want to bring for the evening, the outfits that you'll want to bring for the daytime, including for those days in port and shore excursions, as well as the things that you absolutely don't want to forget. So whether this is your first cruise or you just need a little refresher, I hope that this video can be helpful for you. Now, before I get started, I did want to mention that if you find this video helpful, informative, or enjoyable in any way, then please do give the video a big thumbs up. I really do appreciate it. And of course, please consider subscribing to the channel if you haven't done so already. Okay, let's get started. So before you plan your cruise outfits and what to wear on your cruise, there are two things to consider. The first one is the itinerary and the weather, and generally what you expect it to be on your cruise. So of course, if you're on a Caribbean cruise, you'll expect to wear lighter clothing than you would expect in Alaska or a cooler destination. And the second is your cruise line and your cruise line dress code. Yes, even though cruise lines have become generally more casual than they were even a few years ago, cruises are different than land vacations, and they do actually have dress codes, and they do have rules even as to what you can wear in the restaurants. Now, on the most part, this is not something to worry about. I will go over some dress suggestions. Now, as a general overview, most cruise lines are resort casual during the day and most evenings of a cruise. I'll explain some suggestions a little bit later on in the video. And you'll often have, well, one or even two formal nights for a 7-day cruise, and you might have more if it's a longer cruise. Now, some cruise lines have done away with an official formal night, and they've instead replaced it with another version of it. So Celebrity has a chic night, another cruise line might have a dress your best night, but either way, it is a night or two where you are dressing up a little bit more fancy than you would on a regular night of a cruise. Now, I'd love to know from you what cruise line you're going to be sailing on. Please let me know in the comments below, because the cruise line dress codes are a little bit different. Now, just to kind of go over them very quickly, if you're sailing on Norwegian Cruise Line, that is on the spectrum of the least dressy cruise lines. And if you're sailing on Cunard, that is on the spectrum of the most dressy or the most formal cruise lines. Everything else is somewhere in the middle, with those more family oriented cruise lines like Carnival and Royal Caribbean being a little bit less dressy and a little bit less traditional than cruise lines like Holland America, Celebrity, and Princess. Now, two things you should know for the main dining room. In the main dining room in the evening time, that is really when the dress code applies, and that is when they do tend to be strict on a couple of things. So two things that might surprise you is that shorts are usually not allowed in the main dining room or any of those nicer restaurants. So that includes even if you're on a hot weather itinerary. So make sure that you do bring at least one pair of pants for your cruise. And the other thing is that you can't wear any flip-flops or Crocs on most cruise lines in the main dining room, or really any pool wear at all. So you can wear sandals that are nicer sandals, loafers, closed toe shoes. Just make sure that you bring something other than true pool wear. Okay, so let's go through and plan what to wear for the day, for excursions, for the evening, including formal night, for embarkation day, and even for disembarkation day. Now, I do also have a list of things that you don't want to forget and things that you want to remember, and that will come up at the end of this video. Now, I thought the way that we could do this is we could pretend that we're getting ready for a 7-day cruise. Now, of course, if you're getting ready for a 10-day cruise or a longer cruise, then just bring a couple of more outfits or plan on doing a little bit of laundry. And I should mention that the things that I'm mentioning, obviously, you have your own style, so if you like things a little more dressy, then that's great. And if you like things a little more casual, that's okay too. Day wear. Now, day wear is going to consist of really two types of outfits. So the clothing or the outfits that you're going to wear on the ship during sea days, and the items that you're going to want to wear in the cruise ports. Now, they may sometimes be the same, like when it comes to bathing suits and cover-ups, but sometimes they may be a little bit different. Now, you can expect on the cruise ship that you can dress pretty casually during the daytime. So if this is a warm weather cruise, then you'll want to wear shorts and a t-shirt or maybe a sundress. So any of that's fine, a polo shirt and a pair of shorts. Of course, if the weather is cool, a pair of jeans and a sweater. Now, things that you'll want to pack and bring with you for your sea days include at least 2 bathing suits for a 7-day cruise. I probably would bring 3. Bring a couple of cover-ups as well. Something to note is that when you do go inside from the pool deck, like even if you go to the buffet, you are going to need to wear a cover-up or even to dress a little bit to go inside the cruise ship. Now, when planning what clothing to bring for your sea days, other things to think about is workout wear. Are you going to be working out on those days? If you are, then you'll want to bring something like that, including some runners. And if you think you might be going inside and you might be playing bingo, or maybe you're going to be shopping during the day or doing any of the activities that are maybe inside the cruise ship, you may want to change your clothes. Well, you probably will want to change your clothes and put on a sundress or a clean pair of shorts and a shirt. Now, of course, it doesn't mean you have to have a different outfit for every day. You can have 2 or 3 pairs of shorts and some different shirts that you can mix and match, and that all works too. Now, you might be wondering, what should you wear on embarkation day? So embarkation day is actually pretty casual when you do board the ship. So you'll want to wear something that's comfortable, though you might want to wear something that's cute as well, because of course it's a great time to take some photos. So that's something to think about. Now, a lot of people, if they're going on a Caribbean cruise or a warm weather cruise, may actually wear a bathing suit underneath their clothing. Or if you're bringing an embarkation day bag, I will leave a video at the end of this one all about what you must pack in that. You may want to bring your bathing suit and cover up and leave it in your carry-on bag and just change in your cabin when you do board the ship. Now, don't forget to bring comfortable shoes. You may be walking a lot on that day and you do want to be comfortable. So probably skip the heels and save those for the evening. So what should you wear on shore excursions or on cruise port days? So I have some really handy tips here. So first of all, of course, obviously you're going to dress for whatever the weather is and you're going to dress for the destination. And as well, the activity. So if you're doing a beach activity, then you can wear a bathing suit and a cover up and you're going to be just fine in that. However, oftentimes excursions that are beach excursions will include a stop in the town to shop afterwards. So what I like to do is bring sort of a comfortable sundress that I can throw over my bathing suit after, and that just looks a little nicer than walking in the streets with a cover up. Now, I often bring a second pair of flip-flops as well, and I throw them in my tote because sometimes my flip-flops that I might have worn to the beach may not have been the most comfortable, and I want something a little bit more comfortable to walk in. Now, if you're doing an active excursion, of course, make sure that you dress for that. Maybe it's a hiking excursion or something, so make sure you bring the proper shoes, make sure you bring breathable clothing, make sure that you bring water bottles and a backpack. And don't forget, if you're going to be on the beach or on an excursion where it is going to be very hot and sunny, that you probably are going to want to bring a baseball cap or a wide-brimmed hat and some sunglasses and a beach bag with your towels. Now, something to note of something that you cannot wear in some of the destinations. Now, I have 2 tips for you. If you're going on any tours, especially, this is very important. So ladies, make sure that you do bring a shawl or a scarf to cover your shoulders. Now, oftentimes, if you are going to go into a church, like including the Vatican, for instance, or if you're going to be going into a synagogue or a mosque, sometimes there are these really, really wonderful excursions or places that you can stop into, and you do need to cover your shoulders. At the same time, sometimes you might be shopping and there's air conditioning in the shops, and after a whole day in the sun, it is nice to have a little something to cover your shoulders. And secondly, find out what the decorum, or if there's anything that you shouldn't be wearing in some of the ports. The reason I mention this is because camouflage is actually illegal in some of the Caribbean ports. So this is actually something to watch for, and probably I would leave any camouflage clothing at home if I was going on a Caribbean cruise. Now, what to wear for the evenings on a cruise. Now, if you do plan to eat in the main dining room or any of those like fancier restaurants during the cruise in the evening, then you'll really be subject to that dress code. If you do decide to have some nights where you maybe eat at the buffet or maybe you eat like next to the pool, then you really don't have to think about the dress code and you can dress pretty casually. But let's assume now that we're heading to the main dining room and we want to follow the dress code. So most cruises, you're going to have 2 formal nights on a 7-day cruise or 2 dressy nights. So for ladies, this is going to mean usually a cocktail dress. It could also mean an evening gown if you feel like getting a little more dressy. If you feel like being a little bit less dressy, a little black dress works, or even just a nicer dress or a pantsuit. For men, most of the time, this is going to mean a dark suit or even a tuxedo on those more formal cruise lines. Now, just a little tip as you are packing, something to remember is make sure that you put your shoes, whatever you're going to be wearing with your dress or your suit, put your shoes together with them, your belt, your tie, any of those things, so you just don't forget to pack anything that you would need for that formal night. Now, I'd love to know from you, do you like to dress up for formal nights? Do you prefer to skip it? Let me know your thoughts on that in the comments below. Now, the rest of the evenings are going to be either smart casual or casual, or there may even be some parties or some theme nights, which we'll talk about in just a minute. So when the dress code is casual or smart casual, usually what people wear is for men. They might wear some khakis or some Dockers, that kind of thing, and maybe a polo or a short sleeve or long sleeve casual dress shirt. Something else that men can wear is on most cruise lines now, they are actually allowing you to wear dark, nice jeans. So while not everybody will be wearing jeans, most cruise lines do check your dress code, but most cruise lines are now allowing it. However, still the shorts, usually very frowned upon, and some cruise lines will not even let you in the dining room in shorts. So definitely something to watch for. Now, ladies, it always seems like we have it a little bit easier when it comes to dressing, at least for those casual nights. You can wear a sundress or a casual dress. You can also wear capri pants or palazzo pants. You can even wear some nice white jeans or some dark jeans, just paired with a nice little top. Now, ladies, I have a little tip for you. It is going to be most of the time cool in the main dining room, in the theaters. So if you are wearing something that doesn't cover your shoulders, like spaghetti straps, make sure to bring a shawl, make sure to bring something that does cover your shoulders. Now, before I share the things that you absolutely don't want to forget, the things that you need to remember in terms of what to wear on a cruise, let's talk about one very sad outfit that you need to plan for. Yes. This is the disembarkation or the debarkation day outfit. Now, inevitably on every cruise, you will possibly spot the couple or maybe the group of friends that are dressed a little bit fancy for debarkation day morning. And probably that's because they forgot to leave out clothing for the last morning of their cruise. So definitely make sure, it doesn't need to be a special outfit. It can be whatever you traveled in. So whatever you wore for embarkation, it can be maybe your yoga pants, a tracksuit, a pair of jeans. It really doesn't matter. Shorts and a t-shirt, anything that you want. So just make sure that before you go to bed, if you decide to do the traditional disembarkation where the crew is going to take your luggage away, that you do save an outfit out for the disembarkation morning, as well as for the nighttime, some sleepwear. So here are a few extra things and things that you don't want to forget. So don't forget to bring closed toe shoes. If you think that you'll do any of the activities on the cruise ship, including going to the fitness center or maybe doing the zip line, there's just a lot of things that you won't be able to actually participate in if you don't have closed toe shoes. So make sure you bring that. And make sure you bring socks at the same time. You also need those. Remember to bring a rain jacket, a poncho, and even an umbrella. Unfortunately, the weather is just never 100% guaranteed, so make sure to have that on your cruise. Make sure, even if you're on a Caribbean cruise, that you do bring at least one sweater or pullover. You never know when you're going to have a bit of a cool day. Consider bringing one comfy outfit. So I mean a tracksuit, I mean yoga pants, just something super comfy. I know oftentimes we don't think about it for a cruise vacation, but on a night where you might be watching a movie under the stars or maybe walking along the promenade deck and it's a bit cool, it can be nice to have something just super comfy. Make sure to bring comfortable shoes. So a cruise is never the time to try out any new shoes. Make sure to break them in before the cruise and make sure that you are comfortable. Don't forget sunglasses. Even if you're in Alaska, polarized sunglasses are really important to have. Consider bringing a small evening bag. It can be really handy to have your lip gloss, your phone, your cruise card, all of those items in them, rather than holding things separately in the evening on your cruise. So those are some of the tips that I have. I'd love to hear from you. What are your tips for what to wear on a cruise and what people should not forget? Now, I hope that this video has been helpful for you. If it has been, please do give it a big thumbs up. I really do appreciate it. And if you haven't subscribed to the channel, please do so. I'd love to have you here within the LifeWell Cruise community. I'm leaving a video right at the end of this one about what to pack for your cruise carry-on bag. Very important, so make sure that you do watch that next. Oh, and in case you were wondering, this dress is a dress that I will probably be wearing on my next cruise. If you do like it and if you want to take a look, it is from Amazon, and I will leave the link below in the comments. Bye for now. Happy cruising.